Your Excellency, the President of the Republic of Armenia, guests from the diplomatic corps, students, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor for me to have you here today in Sapienza's Classical Art Museum to celebrate an important event. Armenia is one of the oldest nations on the earth, first to have accepted Christian faith in the year 301, the common era. Our country holds an impressive and unique cultural heritage. Armenia's churches, monasteries, the Armenian tradition in Europe, in Italy, and specifically in the Rome, are an important part of this cultural heritage. This is why, Your Excellency, we have invited you to visit Sapienza and to see a memorandum of understanding between Sapienza and the Ministry of Education, Science, Culture and Sport of the Republic of Armenia, aiming to further develop and improve mutually beneficial cooperation in the field of education and research. Sapienza has a long-standing tradition in Armenian studies. Many of our researchers and professors have worked on specific aspects, ranging from history of arts to late history, from Oriental studies to linguistics. Moreover, Armenian language and culture has been taught autonomously continuously in our faculty of letters and philosophy. Armenian studies at Sapienza can be first identified with the precious magisterium of Walter Velarde and Giorgio Raimondo Cardona, with both work in the Armenian language. His language was studied by Velarde in the early and late years of his career, focusing on etymological problems of his lexicon, seen from the point of view of Indo-European studies. He believed that thorough knowledge of Armenian is essential to gain a full understanding of the Indo-European family of languages. Armenians have never remained confined to their homeland. Since ancient times, they have projected themselves outwards, while remaining deeply attached to their motherland. As you know much better than any of us, the President, your people reached half of Eastern Anatolia and Sub-Caucasus to create the Kingdom of Cilicia. Outside of historical Armenia and already in the Middle Ages, established colonies not only in the Middle East and in Europe, but also in Iran, India, and other parts of the East. More recently, the Armenian diaspora has spread through the world from Europe to the Americas. Studying American Armenian history, civilization, and languages allows us to address highly topical issues. Such as the relations between peoples, the reciprocal influence between different cultures, and the outcome of regular migration, and to foster interdisciplinary research. Considering its center in the Italian university system, its tradition in Oriental and classic studies, and its presence in a city that hosts the world's greatest cultural heritage, Sapienza is the most suitable academic institution to post a position of Armenian studies. It is confirmed also by the long-lasting relation that binds the city of Rome to Armenia and the Armenian people, witnessed today by the presence of prestigious Armenian institutions in our city. For all these reasons, we are convinced that the establishment of a new academic position of Armenian studies in our university will fill a gap in Sapienza's teaching hope, and they will provide the basis for fruitful collaboration with other cultural areas that have been studied in our university. We are committed to do so in the nearest future with the help and support of your excellency and of the Embassy of the Republic of Armenia in Rome. Thank you very much. And
I usually don't get excited when I have to make a speech for public or public politics. But it's an old habit whenever I go to university and the young professor started. And when the first time I entered a class with 150 students, and basically, I was the same age as the students. I had to keep their attention for 90 minutes. Huge challenge. When I come to university, I still have the same challenge. It's really a great pleasure for me to be at university. Somehow when you enter university, you also get relaxed. You also, university, like religion, puts you in the right place in your life. Makes you small. Compared with the size of the university, compared with the size of knowledge, compared with the size of the power of that knowledge. And it makes you philosophical about life. Yes, whatever is happening today, it's a great event. And that's both philosophical as an event, but also something very, very important and practical. Because knowing each other and understanding the world and humans worldwide is the same. Hard work, like my first profession as a physicist, to understand the universe. This is the universe of humans, living in a small planet. And you can just basically agree that it's small, because we just cross in a couple of minutes holes where huge treasures of humanity are kept. Are kept in order to give to the next generation and educate them in the right way. That whatever we're doing, be that in Parthenon, and wherever we keep them, be that in Athens or in London, British Museum, they belong to each of us. And I'm proud to say, as it was mentioned, that Armenia being one of the oldest nations on this planet, and a unique nation, one of the unique ones that stayed in its place, steady, for thousands of years. I've accumulated a lot of knowledge. I have accumulated a lot of know-how and culture that I think it's our duty to also to share to everybody. And when I think about this memorandum of understanding between the university and the Ministry of Education and Science in the Republic of Armenia, I think about sharing. Well, that's one of the most important things in our life. I think we are sharing with knowledge, sharing with what you know with others, sharing with your emotions, sharing with your passion, sharing with your love. Without that, we will not be human. And this is the most important part, sharing of knowledge and understanding. Where does Armenian language stand? It's a unique language. Rome was great. Rome has conquered the world. And has conquered in many ways, both militarily, politically, but also through culture. It was dominant culture in the world for centuries and centuries. And it's still dominant culture in the world. Italian, Roman culture is so important and so huge. Because people do know, they have seen it. Because people come to Rome, they come to Italy. There are huge remnants of that culture everywhere in the world, up to the north of England. And going up to Africa, north of Africa. And it carries a message which is not about politics, which is not about military power, it's about being a human, creating art, science, culture. In the case of Armenia, yes, indeed, we are a unique nation that we live on the same place, which is today Eastern Anatolia. And it's understandable because we Armenians firmly believe that we have to get, and it's a part of our identity, when you ask who is an Armenian. Yes, Armenian is today someone that maybe his family name has ending IAN. But we're not unique. There are some other nations that have some parts of their population have an IAN, be that in Iran, be that in Afghanistan, be that in India. Are there Armenians that have forgotten about their homeland, or they are not Armenians? Doesn't matter. But the big part of people believe that one of our identities is our holy mountain of Ararat. Like Jews have their holy mountain, and they firmly believe that that's their homeland, and they are called to gather one day around the mountains. Armenians always knew that their homeland is around Mount Ararat. And it's a dramatic experience to take Armenians if you want to understand them. It's a nation like me. I wake up every morning. From my house, I can see Mount Ararat. From my house, every day, one experience is there to look is, can I see mountain or not? It's covered with clouds, or it's open, it's bright, it's sunny day, and it's welcoming you. But it's a very strange experience because your holy mountain is just on the border between Armenia and Turkey. But the dream and belief and identity is there. So this nation is a nation that believes that their homeland and our homeland of all Armenians, not only 3.5 million in Armenia, but maybe 12, 15 million worldwide, the homeland is there. Another identity of Armenians today is our Christianity. I think, I don't know why, we were rushing to become Christian. And it was much more safer life staying pagans, surrounded by non-Christian states. But somehow Armenians like to be one of the first. And we became Christian real one earlier than Rome. And we still carry this identity of ours with you. And another identity that I would like to share with you is our language. That's what you spoke about, Armenian language belonging to an important branch of Indo-European languages. Yes, indeed, language is a huge mine of knowledge. It carries not only your own identity, but also your relations, interactions with other nations, with connection. And it's fascinating. what you can learn learning language. So I'm so happy that I'm present today here. Not because I'm the president of the Republic, but as a pure Armenian, as someone that values knowledge and education and science, that in the heart of Rome, in this wonderful university, there'll be, to start with, someone who will do studies on Armenian studies. Be that initially studying Armenian language, maybe tomorrow a bit wider. Hopefully one day it will become something else. But that will be an important and very important link that will connect not only current Rome with current Yerevan or Armenia, but also it will be for that link through the through the pattern of history, taking us down up to 2000 and further down years, when these two nations had interactions. So I'm immensely proud, and I will remember this day being present at the signing ceremony. And I hope one day this will become both here and in Armenia much bigger operation. And I have seen them in many parts of the world. I've seen them in the United States, I've seen them in Russia. And these corporations can create huge impact and huge successes. Just one of the examples is relations between the state hermitage in St. Petersburg with Armenia. Because academics that were basically born were living in St. Petersburg and the Leningrad, where the core of those were doing archaeological research in Armenia and found that Yerevan, the capital city of Armenia, is around 3,000 years old. Oh, and it had a old name and a movie. So, as a discovery, I think if there was a Nobel Prize in archaeology, probably those great names were worth it to give, to be given Nobel Prize. So I hope that this small beginning was the beginning of something big. In 1984, when I first entered Cambridge University, and as a Soviet scientist doing research in astronomy, cosmology, and gravitational theory, one of the first days I asked the director of my institute, Professor Martin Rees, who's Lord Rees now, said, Martin, I would love very much to go to Oxford. You don't ask that sort of question in English. It's the other place. It's like in Harry Potter's story, you don't announce the name of the bad guys in the other place. But I wanted to go the other place because before that, years ago, a department of Armenians, first as a chair, individual, then as the department of Armenian studies, has been developed. And it became a real bridge between science, politics, knowledge, friendship between UK and Armenia. And I hope this one here is a small but important beginning of something very big. And I can assure you that I will be one of those that will fully support whatever the small beginning is going to do. And you can count on me. Thank you very much. Who is signing? Grazie.